watching Don't Share Boxing Nation.
Dante's Boxing Nation, what's going on, guys? So Ryan Garcia and Tank Davis, they just made it official. Despite everyone telling Ryan Garcia not to take the fight, trying to protect him, trying to keep the training wheels on, Ryan Garcia has took the training wheels off and has refused to go the Canelo Alvarez route, which is why you have to give Ryan Garcia a lot of credit, win, lose, or draw. So when I say Ryan and Tank, they've made it official, what I mean is they've made it official that both of them want the fight next. And that's great news because that means we can't be too far away from the contracts actually being signed. And there's no doubt this will be one of the biggest fights of the year. Boxing fans are really, really excited about this fight. But at the same time, you have a lot of people scratching their head and wondering, why does Ryan Garcia want to fight Tank Davis, someone so dangerous, someone who is such a favorite to beat him? Why would he go after a fighter like that? And Ryan Garcia, he finally explained why. He explained why he really, really wants this fight no matter what anyone tells him. He's determined to make this fight come to fruition. So this is what Ryan said. He said, I grew up in an area where there were a lot of tanks. I got bullied a lot by the kids next door, the kids at school. They would make fun of me, throw me on the ground. I was scared of confrontation. When I see Tank, I see that bully. That's why Garcia versus Davis is going to be one of the biggest fights you've ever seen. I have to make the bully want to bully me or shame him. I got to do something to get him in that ring. End quote. Wow. It's really amazing when you hear some of these boxer stories and even the MMA fighters, because I've heard some boxers say this. I've heard MMA fighters say this. I mean, MMA fighters like Israel Adesanya comes to mind. A man who pretty much is the new John Jones, the new Anderson Silva of MMA, talks about how he used to always get bullied before he got into MMA. And then you hear the other stories where you have fighters that they were bullies in school and they decided to turn to boxing. Tim Bradley said that he was a bully. So you just never know what type of background these fighters have. So when it comes to Ryan Garcia, getting this Tank fight is very personal because he feels he's confronting the fears that were in him as a child when it came to bullies. And even though Ryan Garcia is almost 5 inches taller than Tank Davis, Ryan feels that he's actually the David going up against Goliath. So at the end of the day, I really respect Ryan Garcia for wanting to take the Tank Davis fight. Ryan Garcia is willing to get in the ring with someone that Teofimo Lopez doesn't even want to get in the ring with. I mean, by Teo's own admission. Because Teo Sr. just recently said, fighting Tank Davis, Devin Haney, and Shakur Stevenson, it makes no sense right now. If it were up to them, they would only fight Kambosos, Ryan Garcia, or the winner of Ramirez versus Josh Taylor. That's how much respect Lopez has for Tank Davis. And Ryan Garcia is willing to get in the ring with him next. Not only get in the ring with him, but push for the fight. Crazy when you really think about it, because when Teofimo Sr., when he says it makes no sense to fight those guys, if you think about it, he's actually telling Lopez the same thing that everyone close to Ryan Garcia is telling him. You don't want to fight that guy right now. Let's not fight Tank. That's too dangerous of a fight. Let's go to Australia, make this money, fight Kambosos. Let's, you know, probably try to get Ryan Garcia in the ring. But let's leave that damn Tank alone. That's what everyone, or I won't say everyone, but that's pretty much what Ryan's team said. And that's what Lopez's team said. But the difference is Ryan said, nah, I won't be moved on this one. I'm going to do whatever it takes to make this Tank Davis fight. You got to give Ryan a lot of credit for that. A lot of credit. I have a lot of confidence that this fight is definitely going to happen, because this is exactly what Floyd Mayweather and Gervonta Tank Davis wanted from the time that they actually beat Leo Santa Cruz. They wanted the Ryan Garcia fight. Their plan was to fight Ryan Garcia and then fight Teofimo Lopez. According to close sources I talked to, that was the plan. So speaking of Lopez, if Garcia pulls off the upset and beats Tank Davis, that would be right up Lopez's alley, because that was the fight that he said he was willing to take. He said he's not interested. He said when it comes to Tank and Devin Haney, they're not ready. He said Devin got to wait 3 to 5 years. And then later on, he said, well, I'll fight him now. Give me $10 million. You know, he said Tank Davis got to do a whole lot more. But then he said, but I'll go ahead and fight Ryan Garcia now. I'll fight Kambosos now. So my point is, if Ryan wins, then there's no doubt that's exactly what Lopez would want. But if Gervonta Tank Davis wins that fight, that is going to put an enormous amount of pressure on Lopez to take the fight. Because first of all, Lopez wanted the Ryan Garcia fight himself. So if Gervonta beats him to Garcia, it'll be very difficult to justify not fighting Gervonta Tank Davis. Because Teofimo Lopez, he's going to most likely fight George Kambosos next. We all know that Ryan Garcia or Gervonta Tank Davis versus Ryan Garcia is going to be way more successful than a Teofimo Lopez versus George Kambosos fight. Which means if Gervonta Tank Davis wins that fight, and I'm only using his name because that's the person that Lopez said it makes no sense to fight. So that means if Tank beats Ryan Garcia, Lopez will have no excuse not to take the fight. That's all I got for now, guys. I'm on to the next one. All right, now check this out, guys. If you're looking to repair eczema scars, burns and bruises, dark spots and blemishes, then this right here is the perfect product for you guys. It's called L.O. DeKey Face and Body Oil. Athletes and top-ranking boxers, they're also using it after training to reduce swelling and inflammation and to ease the pain. So get yours today. Go to LODeKey.com. Like them on Facebook and follow them on Instagram. Listen, I'm telling you guys right now, in the world that we live in today, one of the most important things in life to have is a good lawyer. And I can vouch for this one right here, because this brother is my personal lawyer. So if you need any type of legal representation, if you need legal advice, if you're having problems on YouTube, on your regular job, or whatever it is, contact lawyer, mediator, and business consultant, Issa Israel's Law Firm. I've been knowing this man for a while, and he has been a true blessing to me. I'm telling you, he's affordable. He will work with you. But most importantly, he's not going to just treat you like a customer. He will have your best interest. So to get in contact with him, go to iilawfirm.com or consultsglobal.com. Fellas, I've got some great news for you. If you've lost your hair or have a receding hairline, the time has come when you can finally get your hairline back through a process called scalp micropigmentation. So here's how it works. It's a hair tattoo that replicates the look of your hair follicles when you have fully shaved it down. Basically, you will end up with a haircut shape up or an edge up. What they do is they tattoo small dots that look like hair follicles in the areas where you have lost your hair, and then blend it with your existing hair. You can even choose what type of hairline you want, hard shape up or soft and natural finish. And to maintain it, all you gotta do is shave your hair every few days, which is something you already were probably doing anyway. So if you wanna get this hookup for my brothers out there in the UK and Europe, make sure you check out The Scalpedist on Instagram. And for my brothers out there in the States, make sure you go ahead and contact my man Scalp Carolinas on Instagram. And when you go on their pages, you can see for yourself what these guys look like before. I mean, these guys are literally hair magicians. I've never seen anything like this before. But all I can tell you guys is this is a serious game changer for us men. So make sure you get in contact with Scalpedist and Scalp Carolinas on Instagram.